My name is Dave Victor McMillan, and I'm a forensic investigator. I search for the remains of those missing in action from the Vietnam conflict. Some call me a mercenary or a feral. Most call me the MIA hunter.
Hey! I know it feels to expect to get a best shape, but they won't let you forget that you're the underdog, and you got to be twice as good.
Yeah, yeah.
I know it feels people to stop, turn around and stare, signify a little bit, and low-rave me, yeah.
I was born and raised into a blue-collar family in Queensland, Australia. I didn't know my father well when I was younger. I became an angry young man, self-destructive, but fate stepped in, and I had to help him recover some lost money. He told me that he had bought me a ticket to Vietnam, and that he wanted me to come and visit him. I just fell in love with the country, its people, its culture, its language. After 10 years here, I'm completely fluent in Vietnamese. It's a skill which is very helpful when I'm in the field. I walked away from everything and never looked back. In late 2009, I was contacted by Rory Flynn, daughter of my idol, Errol Flynn, and sister of Sean Flynn. She wanted me to search for her brother, who at that time had been missing in action for over 40 years. It was a decision which was to change my life forever. A 40-year paper trail led me to the village of Phak A Dong in Kampong Cham, Cambodia.
Can you get rid of all the people, please? These are feet, man.
They're Western teeth too, look.
Yeah.
There's bits of human skull here. Oh my God, man.
It's a very emotional moment.
We found it, mate.
His fate was a mystery until now.
Although the remains did not match the DNA sample of Sean Flynn that the US government claims to have on file, I continue to work with Rory Flynn and will never give up my search to find her brother. After I returned from the Cambodian mission in 2010, my father approached me about forming a real squad.
It's good to get the team back together, ain't it?
Yeah, for sure, man.
The first time David came back from Cambodia when he'd found those remains, he was slightly off his tree, if you like, because he'd been living with these remains in his room before they handed him over to the American embassy.
We're looking at an area of a couple of hundred metres in an area which was completely bombed out.
We're talking 500 to 1,000 pound bombs. You hit one and there'll be nothing left.
Check that out, Brantley. Bouncing Betty.
I would not monkey with that thing, man.
Oh, well. Worst it can do is maim you or kill you, man.
My name's Brantley. I was born very southern tip of Indiana. We are real Americans. Family been in America since 1628. Quite proud of that.
We're crossing over the Mekong River into Phuoch Ma, where we pulled off the last mission, so our security is probably... it's high stakes when we get out there.
I know the scale of the game he's playing. Sometimes I don't think he does.
All right.
Dave has shown up entire government forensics teams that have been at this stuff for 40 years. He's shown them up.
I'm a peaceful person, but I know how to defend myself. I've been doing martial arts since I was 5 years old. If someone says they're going to kill me, I say, well, good luck.
When you hire Rambo, you get Rambo.
I saw him turn the corner here, man. They probably just cut to the right again.
You hear the phrase, I know a guy who knows a guy who knows a guy. Bobby Quach is the guy.
Dave and I, we are a good team.
When I started working with him in the security industry and stuff, he had looked fully into my past. He was there to spy on me. I knew it, right? That's part of what makes him so good at what he does.
Hey! Hi, I'm Bob Watch.
Jessica, nice to meet you. My mom is white, American, and my father is from Vietnam. I'd like to think that I am one of the positive things that came out of the war. I wouldn't exist if there wasn't a Vietnam War.
Come on, Jess, come in first.
We're really gonna walk through there?
I spend sometimes 14 hours in the field a day in areas where it's landmine infested.
Right, Brantley? Coming
to what? Yeah, man, I'm waiting to see what you new guys are gonna do here, man. Obviously, they're not moving. Look at her, man. Look at this. She's not moving.
Yeah. Jess, come on, move. Brantley, get your shoes off. Jess, come on.
Oh, my God.
Imagine, like, walking through
rocky road or marshmallows or something.
These guys all got captured here. 11 of them went missing right here in this intersection.
It's the tangibility of having remains and knowing exactly what happens to someone. And if I can somehow be a part of bringing closure to someone, then I want to be a part of it.
This is a step in a different direction for me.
I have a family here, and I've got kids here.
I definitely have a belief that Dave knows where these people are. I wouldn't be on board doing this right now.
If we can knock this guy off the list and get his DNA data, we can compare him against the guy that we pulled out of the ground 2 years ago to this day, right?
Not government, we're not United Nations, not here to take anybody to court. We just want to recover remains, get them back to the families, and they accept that. And with the equipment we need, with the GPR, the ground penetrating radar, and this new system, this human remains detection system, which imitates a cadaver dog, we can go in there and pinpoint exactly the location of these people. We can find them.
The dead are dead. It's only a matter of time before we're going to find them, but helping those people, that's more important to me.
Well, growing up, my brother was 4 years my senior. For two guys that were 4 years apart, we were pretty close. He went with a squadron that was stationed aboard the USS Enterprise, and I got word that on the 19th of May, my brother had been shot down over North Vietnam on a mission. My brother, at the time, was listed as missing in action. And until I know the truth, I feel like anything less than real closure is like an abandonment of my brother.
I spoke briefly to Luck Patterson about his brother's case. The MIA families often voice their frustrations over the lack of progress and communication shown to them by the same government their missing relative bravely sacrificed their life for.
The things that we've been led to believe that they would have moved these graves multiple times, that's not true.
It's easier for them to close cases without finding remains.
So for the 40 plus years that they had the nerve to tell my mother that they were doing everything they could do to bring him home, they lied to her face.
They wanted just to put his personal effects that had been found in a box and intern them. And she told them no. And they said, well, what would it take for you to do this? She said, bring me a fucking finger. We'll put it in a box and we'll bury it.
Dave Victor McMillan, the MIA hunter. So I've dedicated my life to searching for the remains of long-lost heroes from a forgotten war and to bring closure and hope to their long-suffering families around the world. This is my Bone Squad, and these are our cases.